This is a production of Cornell University.
At the moment. Now, there's other stuff going on here, and what we're hoping to learn this time is when does the plant make the switch, because it is sequential, from being a female to being a male. When you see what's inside of this, you'll see hundreds of really small florets. They don't each have petals. They're just little sex organs, okay? But the male and female expression is separated by 24 hours, or maybe it isn't, maybe 12 hours, but it's separated by some time. And what happens in almost all chamber flowers is the pollinator enters first, presumably with pollen from the last flower it visited, because they get fooled over and over again. And they rub against the female organs of the flowers, which are receptive first. So the first thing the plant does is we'll take the pollen that you've got on your bodies and we'll fertilize our ovules. Done. That happens in the first 5 minutes of anything entering here. Then what they do is they hold those pollinators captive overnight. They warm up the chamber, which gives them a nice energetic reward, okay? And it protects them against predators, because most of their predators don't follow them into chambers like this. And then in the morning, they shower them with their own pollen or make them walk past the male flowers, which are now finally mature, on their way out. And then they go do it again the next night. Now, you would think this must be harming these insects, because after a while, they're going to miss out on chances to lay eggs, etc. And some of them do die in the chambers. The dead horse arum in Sardinia and Corsica has a bad habit of killing its pollinators. On the other hand, most of the insects that do this for a living mate multiple times, and they mate on the dead bodies or on the cow patties. So what they do in that chamber sometimes is make more. All right. So the rewards that they're not getting nectar and pollen to eat like other pollinators do. What they're getting is a warm place out of the rain, away from predators, and a chance to maybe get a second mating or a third mating, and then do it again the following night. And these things are so rare that they're not going to wipe out a population of blowflies, which are, as most people know, very abundant and breed very quickly. If my cat brings mice or voles into our house, we've got blowflies in a week. We don't know how they get into the house, but they find it. They're very good at doing that. So the plants are opportunists.
This has been a production of Cornell University, on the web at cornell.edu.